When I take a broader view of Homo sapiens and humanity, my point of view is that in the history of our existence, we have never had better education, we have never had better health care, we have never had better wealth. We have all of the tools and elements and resources available to us to be profoundly happy.
But we are bodies out of balance.
Because in every tissue, there is a role for omega-3, omega-6 balance. And because the American diet is so out of balance, we just have all kinds of things that could have been prevented.
The incidence of things like depression and aggression and violence are related to omega-3 deficiency. We're really at a crossroads in our history in terms of just a lack of omega-3 in our diets and the absolute need to add more omega-3.
The Global Forum of Health has predicted that in 8 years' time, mental ill health will be the second burden of ill health worldwide.
I want to know to what extent this is attributable to a nutritional deficiency that we have the power to correct.
In 1971, the dietary concern in relation to health was heart disease. That, let's put it bluntly, bad fats, these are saturated fats and things like that, were considered to be the major cause of atherosclerosis and hence coronary heart disease. So, knowing that all fat is not bad, and that DHA comes from a fat source, I was deeply concerned that unless something was done about changing the paradigm of food production so that it actually targeted the growth of the brain, that the brain would be next. So I wrote this book, What We Eat Today, and I published it with my wife, and Graham Rose wrote in the Sunday Times that if these guys are right and nothing is done, we're going to become a race of morons. And of course, nothing was done. So the prediction we made was that if you don't do anything, the brain's next. That is exactly what has happened. And it is very scary.
It's really important to know that the brain is just fats. When you look at the bulk of it, it's full of oils and lipids and fats that make this marvelous and unique organ what it is. So how do these lipids and fats get there? Well, some of them our bodies and our mothers can make ourselves through development, but others of these lipids and fats can't be made by the human body and can only be ingested by our diet. So the types of oils and the types of fats you choose to eat actually become who you are. And by what I mean who you are, actually become your brain and therefore become your emotions, become your concentration, and really become your personality and who you are. So I think it's very vital and critically important to know about these fats so you can make better choices about them.
HUFA stands for highly unsaturated fatty acids. And fatty acids are links of carbon all together that we construct for energy and to make hormones and to make membranes. HUFA has a lot of carbon-carbon double bonds, and those are the very important fatty acids for making membranes and also for our inflammatory response. And it's important to know which are omega-3 and which are omega-6 in their relative balance, because too much HUFA that's omega-6 produces an inflammatory response that's very aggressive, very inflamed. If you balance that with omega-3 by reducing omega-6 and increasing omega-3, that inflammatory response is much lower. Your HUFA's balance between omega-3 and omega-6.
Omega-3 and omega-6 fats come from very different sources. The ones that are particularly important and interesting to the brain are called marine omega-3 fats. That's called EPA and DHA. You find them richly concentrated in oysters and in salmon and in all kinds of cold water fish. You know, we can, of course, extract those oils from fish or grow them up in algae and, you know, provide people pills or capsules containing those fish, but for, you know, the millions of years of hominin evolution, these nutrients were packaged as a total nutrient package in fish.
And the only way you can explain the evolution of the human brain is that the early species, primate species, that was ultimately destined to become human was living up the coastline. Probably the estuaries would make the best sense, where there was an abundance of seafood and clean water to drink. Now, if you look at what happened on land, as animals evolved bigger and bigger bodies, their brain size shrank in relation to the body. As animals evolved on land, brain size just simply diminished logarithmically. The only way that Homo sapiens could have avoided the trap of losing brain size as we evolved bigger was actually to be at the seaside using seafood. What we have been doing in recent time is becoming more and more dependent on the land-based food.
And now these oils with one molecular species makes up about 8 or 10% of all the calories that we eat.
One of the major concerns I have is this preponderance of omega-3 deficiency in the world, and especially in the United States. An absolute lack of seafood consumption has led to this, and excessive amounts of omega-6 fatty acids have led to this. And we've known this for quite a few years. We've been testing blood for 30 plus years and have seen these kind of patterns, but only more recently in the past 10 years we've started to know that hearts need omega-3 to be healthy, that brains need omega-3 to be healthy, and that the incidence of things like depression and aggression and violence, Dr. Joe Hiblin from the National Institutes of Health talks about this, are related to omega-3 deficiency.
We have now what I consider to be a vast excess of omega-6 fatty acids. And the reason we have a vast excess of them is we now grow soybeans and corn in huge and vast abundance.
The Industrial Revolution really brought us a lot of grains, and it was a good thing because our country was starving like a lot of countries at that time, so grain production gave us a way to produce a lot of food economically that people could consume, and a lot of those grains have more omega-6 and omega-3. Their storage oil is richer in omega-6 fats and omega-3 fats, and the net result is induction of omega-3 deficiency by eating excessive amounts of omega-6 fatty acids and not enough long-chain omega-3 from things like salmon.
We've got an epidemic in childhood. I call it epidemic of the D's. ADD, ADHD, OCD, ASD, autism spectrum disorder, the big D, diabetes, all these D's. And I must use this line in my practice 4 or 5 times a day. You need an oil change. I'll look at my patients right in the eye, say, Joe, you need an oil change. I say, really? Like an old car. You need an oil change. You've got to boost your omega-3s. Omega-3s help lower the Ds.
What we know is that the omega-6 hormones are more potent, more dynamic than the omega-3 hormones. They both do similar things, but when they go to a receptor, the receptor sort of responds this way to the omega-3, and it responds that way to an omega-6. There's a lot of things that can get out of balance, including your attitude and your mood and your behavior and your arthritis and your asthma and your tumor proliferation and invasiveness. On and on it goes.
Push the omega-6 fatty acids in, you're pushing the omega-3 fatty acids out. So you can do a couple things to push back. You know, you can eat less omega-6 fatty acids, and you can actively choose to restore your brain with omega-3 fatty acids. Now, does this work? And now, after, you know, 20 years of research, we can give very solid answers to those questions. When the trials are done properly, and we actually enroll depressed patients into the trials, and we give them the right formulations of omega-3 fatty acids, predominantly EPA, we see that these omega-3 fatty acids are more effective and more potent than common antidepressants in treating depression.
I think it's no use just taking supplements. You've also got to change your dietary paradigm. Because there's no use taking supplements and then going in and having a mammoth cheeseburger.
Because those supplements are just not going to be as effective because they're working against a big resistance of omega-6. Inside us, there's just 1,000 things going on under the influence and predispositions of the omega-3 and omega-6 hormones. So you pick a subject, you pick a point in your body, and there will be cells responding to that balance.
Now, when we take this change that we've seen in the country, we model that in rodent diets and change from a very low amount of linoleic acid to a very many high amount of linoleic acid, it's as if we've poisoned the soil. And the neurons just start to shrivel, and they just start to sort of die back and don't make as many connections and don't just have the physical potential to connect to one another.
And I explained to my patients, omega-3s are really a nutrient for all organs at all ages. And I call it my head-to-toe nutrient. It's good for the brain, good for the eyes, it's good for the gums, it's good for the skin, it's good for the heart, it's good for the lungs, it's good for the joints, it's good for the gut. I mean, it's a nutrient for all organs at all ages.
Your first medicine is food. And if the food is balanced, you prevent the cause of the signs and symptoms that everybody's paying all this money to treat.
I eat safe, delicious, nutritious seafood 4 to 5 times a week. I look upon seafood, my Alaskan seafood, as my medicine. Every month when it comes, and that nice big package comes to the front door, always right on time. My wife, Martha, says, "Bill, your medicine has arrived." I owe my own health to seafood. So if I, as a doctor, can get parents to love and value the nutritional preventive medicine value of omega-3s, then I feel like a better doctor.
We recommend a HUFA blood test to actually measure the good fats in your blood. Our diets are filled with different types of fat, and essential fatty acids are omega-6 and omega-3, and we want to have a balance of those fatty acids. And the omega-3 HUFA test tells you how much of those good fats are in your blood.
So the more you help them get the blood test, and they go, "Oh my God, is that where I'm at?" And the more you show them, the balance could be anywhere from 80-20 to 20-80. Human body is very flexible depending on all these foods that we eat.
A lot of people that we encounter think they're doing the right things, and God bless them, they are living healthily, but optimization of your omega-3 and omega-6 levels is something that's incredibly important to health. And that simple little test, that little blood spot test, can tell you whether or not you have healthy levels of these fatty acids and whether or not you need to eat more omega-3 or reduce your omega-6 fatty acid intake.
So I always leave them with the message, as I do with my emails, to say, remember, nix the 6 and eat the 3.
If you don't know where you are, you don't know what your risk is. And If you don't know where you are in your blood level, you don't know how happy and how healthy you can possibly be.